You know, someone told me once that in life, you don't always get what you deserve, but you will always get what you negotiate. And when you're negotiating for the price of your home, it's very important that you follow certain rules. And I've seen it many times because I negotiate with a lot of buyers or sellers, and I negotiate with a lot of realtors at the same time. I've been doing this for many years. I've been doing this almost all my life, you know. And one of the best tips I can give you is to make sure that you speak once and listen twice. Because the more you open your mouth, the more money is going to cost you. Number one, plan your approach. It's very important that you know exactly where you want to go with this negotiation. When you're talking to someone across the table and you're negotiating a price, and this is going to be the key for you to sell your house or not sell your house, you need to know exactly where you're going to go. So before you sit down at the table, you need to understand what is the outcome that you want to do and the approach, how you're going to get there. Then the other thing is that you need to focus on your stronger points. You know, why is your house better than other houses on the market, and why you should buy this house at this price, you know? And you need to amplify these points. At the same time, you kind of need to ignore some of the bad points on your house. The more bad points you bring during a negotiation about your house, the less money you're gonna get. You know, unless they specifically ask you about that, I will amplify the good points on your house and leave it at that. You need to stay on track. You cannot be talking and negotiating, because this is like a boxing match. You know, you're going back and forth negotiating. This is not a time to talk about your nephew learning how to ride a bicycle, or this is not a time to talk about the Washington Redskins, how they blew the lead on Sunday. You need to stay on track. That's another mistake a lot of beginners do, in making sure you understand this is a competition. Unfortunately, this is not exactly for to get what you really should deserve or what you think you're gonna get. It is what you're going to do at the table on the boxing ring, and you're negotiating for the most money, and you need to stay focused. You need to remain calm. Very important thing also for you. Do not get excited. You need to keep focused. Do not get involved emotionally about this, because you need to stay on track for all the points that you're trying to make, and do not be emotionally attached to the outcome, and do not show them that. It's a very important factor, because they want to see that either way, you're okay with the results. And then finally, acknowledge the other side, and then tell them, I really appreciate the fact that you want to buy my house. I really appreciate the fact that someone such as you could possibly be enjoying the house I built. You know, because that will make them feel better. And then at the same time, then you add the compromise. I do understand that you want to pay this much, but this is really the lowest I could possibly go, and I hope you understand where I'm coming from. And that's when you just dump the price on them and let them make the decision. And do not let in, because a lot of times the people that negotiating also can be shrewd, and they know how to negotiate, that they're gonna come back at you pointing out all the bad things about your house. You need to remain calm, stay focused, and give them a compliment. I appreciate that you want my house, and I really thank you for the consideration, but this is the least amount I could take, and giving back the price of them. Ultimately, you need to be prepared to walk away. You know, because the minute they see you sweat, they're gonna rob you blind. I can tell you, there's a lot of good people out there negotiating for buyers. You better be prepared, be very careful.